Well, hi everybody, God bless you. Thank you for watching. Yeah, so today I have somebody to hold the camera for me. I get quite a number of thoughts as as I'm driving around. And today the Lord gave me a word for you and struggling to see me. I don't actually need these shades. It's actually raining in Nairobi. Yay, guys, it's raining in Nairobi. We bless the Lord. I don't know whether it's raining where you are, if you're in Kenya. Okay, for those of you who are outside the country, it's been really hot. So it's raining right now, but it's 23 degrees still. So it's a little hot still, yeah? So we bless the Lord. So today the Lord gave me a word for you. And so this is directly not just, like a thought and like something I've just, said, oh, let me teach on this. You know, this is something that the Lord actually told me, speak to my children about this. And he told me to say to you to stop putting him in a box. Stop putting the Lord in a box. He said he doesn't operate like a human being. He's not a human being. So stop putting him in a box. Looking at milestones and saying, oh, you know, I'm supposed to be married by the time I'm 30. And you see now it's late and you begin to panic and you begin to be afraid and start thinking, oh my, you know, my biological clock is ticking. Those are worldly things the Lord said to me to remind you to not to embrace the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewal of the mind. Do not follow the patterns of this world. As children of God, we are in the world, but we're not of the world. And so we must watch out for things that the world has taught us to believe that they are fact. But in the kingdom of God, they are not fact. It's actually putting God in a box. So it could be, oh, you know, we're running late. Oh, you know, when will I have my babies and all that, you know. So the Lord, actually, one of the things the Lord was telling me is, please tell them that when the children of Israel were in a desert and had no rain, I didn't send somebody to deliver, you know, from the stores, you know, like box of Weetabix and box of cereals and box of, naan and all those things. Eh? What God did was that it started raining. And they're like, oh, what's that? It's raining. Oh, ooh. You know, and the Lord really gave me a vision this morning of when rain turned into food. That's the God we serve. That is Yahweh. He does things in a very, you could say, weird way, yeah? I guess that's a worldly way of putting it, weird way, but he certainly does not come in the form and manner that we expect him to come in. So he told me, tell my children to stop putting me in a box. I want to do various things in their lives, but without faith, it's impossible to please me. And so when they lack faith and they think that I'm going to come the way that their dad would have come, I'm going to come the way, you know, the world expects me to come, then it affects you, because without faith it's impossible to please God. And you know, there are behaviors that we can have that affect us in such a way that God can't even move. He cannot move, because now if you've given up, you say, ah, me, I've given up on things to do with marriage. Ah, me, I've given up on my husband. I've given up on my wife. I've given up on my child. So where is God supposed to come through? The other thing he was reminding me is about things to do with provision. That sometimes we look at ourselves and we look at our milestones and we get caught up in thinking, oh, you know, people my age are now married. Okay, maybe now if you're married, you're like, oh, people my age don't live on this side of the hood. People my age are now buying houses. People my age are doing. God is not directed by stories of people my age, okay? God is more than able to look like he's late, like he did with the Lazarus situation. The sisters are saying, oh, but my Lord is smelling, the Lord is more than able to restore and to undo. If he could undo the decay of Lazarus, if he could undo the deadness of Lazarus, even in spite of it having taken long, you know, because maybe they expected that, yeah, if you come when he's still, breathing, or, you know, when it's kind of warm, then perhaps, you know, you could do, we hear that Elijah put himself on top of this corpse and his body, and perhaps, you know, his body weight and the warmth of his body might have been like that recharge thing of, you know, and God's not like that. He made man out of clay and made a woman out of a rib. Have you ever thought about that? Out of a rib. Imagine. You know, when I get to heaven, one of the things I want to ask Papa is, Why a rib? Why a rib? I mean, you think you take a piece of a brain, a chunk of the heart, you know? But a rib? I mean, that sounds so weird. A rib? Really? We're about to get to a place that tends not to have network, so let me just wrap up. Basically, what the Lord is saying is, stop putting me in a box. You know, if you look at Elisha and those men who are cutting trees and cutting woods, they're the prophets and all that. When the axe, which was, an axe's head is heavy. So it falls into this mass of water and, instead of somebody diving, which is the normal way, God tells his prophet, put a stick inside there. What's the relationship between a stick making a really heavy metal axe part float? Yeah, so what's the difference between, what did that stick have to do with it? You know, I think God just loves being God in that he just does things differently. And that's just the way he is. And that's who he is. And one of the things we need to do as we understand the character of God, as we invest in, we may never understand because of our earthly limitation, but as we begin to figure out the character of God, I mean, really, guys, think about it. Joshua on the edge of the Jordan, yeah? Really? So the priests go, and God is in a box, and, you know, they stand over the edge of the Jordan, and their feet touch the water, and the water parts, and, oh, you've gotten a kickoff doing the Red Sea too, isn't it? So, I mean, that's the God. Oh, got into a hole. That's the kind of God we serve. That's our daddy. That's our father. So stop putting it in a box. Trust that he's been God enough, and he's been the only God, really, and he knows what he's doing. So stop limiting him. And then stop those kind of prayers where you're telling him how to come through. Because God will come through from nothing. While you're expecting him to come through from something, he will come through from nothing. I tell you, I don't know how we are supposed to enter this place. I'm going into the Nana school. It's just so weird. So God will, come through in a very strange way if you will just stop limiting him. In fact, make it an adventure to say, I can't wait to see how you do this. Walk on the Lord's right side. Be holy. Make sure you're blameless. And then just take your popcorn out if you're not fasting and enjoy looking out for, I can't wait to see how you're going to do this one. Then journal so that way the next time you're tempted to think God's not going to do it, you are not thinking, you're actually able to say, oh, of course God's going to do it. He's done it before. Why wouldn't he do it now? Okay. That's our. All right, guys. So keep trusting the Lord. Wait upon him and stop putting God in a box. That's not Yahweh. Let him work. Let him be God. Let him do what he does. And let him give you a testimony. And, you know, and by the way, he really gets a kick out of that thing of, squealing, look what he did, hallelujah. So let him be God. Let him be God. He's more than able to cause you to be married at the age of 50 but still have children, if he did it for Sarah, okay? He's more than able to catch up on maybe the things you've been trusting you should be able to achieve, and your parents are looking at you like you're a failure and all that, and within a span of even 3 years or a year, all of a sudden you have everything that you need, and the Lord has come through because it gives him pleasure to give you everything that you need. So be blessed. Have faith in the one you have believed. There's one song that I love. I know who I have believed. I know who I have believed. So believe God and declare, I know who I have believed. And I'm persuaded that he's more than able. He's a good God. He's a good God, guys. Trust him. I know you've been messed up by a few people, but trust him. He's not sitting up there saying, oh, what am I going to do? Who should I mess up today? Oh, you know, let's see. Let's mess up Marie. Let's mess up Kathy. Let's see her cry. Woo-hoo! Can you see her cry? Can you see how embarrassed she is? You know what? If God doesn't come through for you, he has more to lose than you do. Because you've declared that he's your God. So if he seems like he's not coming through for you, then in that case, people are going to look and say, oh, this is how God treats people. Eh? This is how God treats people. You know, there's a verse in the song. There's this song by, I forget her other name, Wanjiru. It's a mother tongue song. But one of the things it says, I think in the last verse, it says, I've seen how you treat your friends. You know, I've seen how you treat your friends. And you know what, guys? God treats his friends really well. If you know how to treat your friends well, God is holy. And so he will do much better than you will do. So just stop putting God in a box. Stop trying to tell him how to be God. And let him do his job. Our job is to be holy. Our job is to honor Christ. Our job is to ensure that the resurrected Christ is known to all and that we are truly a beautiful fragrance of Christ. So God bless you guys. All right? Shalom. Love you. Let's keep on praying. Let's keep pressing in. And let's win souls for the kingdom. Okay? Start inboxing me. I love getting your testimonies about the miracles God is doing for you financially. That's awesome. But I want to start seeing also testimonies of the people you led to Christ. Sasa, there's a lady who told me about... Are we off or we are still on? Oh, you're laughing. Our cameraman is laughing. Oh, because we are bumpy. Okay. All right. Let's stop a little bit. At least I can stop. I'm on a dirt road. So basically, guys, start sending me testimonies of the people who got saved. Sasawa, bear fruit. Bear fruit and much fruit. Amen. Shalom. God bless you. God's going to do everything for you. So stop worrying. Amen. Oh, you wanted guys to have a look at me. But if you say finish before you finish, they hear you.